Neer dosa. I have sona masuri rice here. I have soaked it overnight, washed it until the water ran clear, and now I have drained all the water. And also you would need a cup of coconut. For 2 cups of sona masuri rice, I'm using a cup of coconut, freshly grated coconut. Apart from that, you would need some coconut oil to grease the pan, and you would need a small shallot that is poked into a fork, or a small chopped onion that's also poked into a fork. You can use either of the shallot or the onion. And also you would need something like this to just put your dosas, neer dosas, on this. It's optional, you can always put it on a plate. This gives a nice dry texture, and it's easy to fold if you put on this mesh. So it's made out of some kind of creeper, dried creeper, or a vine, I guess. So if you have, you can use one, or it's optional. And also you would need a non-stick pan, and also some salt to taste. So now let's grind the rice, coconut and salt together in a blender to a fine paste while adding little water. So the paste should be very nice and very creamy. This is the paste of the rice, and this is the consistency, very smooth and thick. Now I'm going to add water into it and balance the consistency, and I'll show you the consistency required. Check the salt as well, as soon as you finish adding water. This is the consistency of the batter. You should be hearing as if it is a water flowing sound, something like that. And it's a very runny consistency. This is how it is. I have checked the salt and added little more. Maybe I have used about 1.5 teaspoon of salt and about 2 cups of water maybe to bring it into this consistency. And now heat your pan on high. It should be fuming hot. And then apply some coconut oil with the shallot that you have poked on the fork. Greasing a non-stick pan is not actually required, but it increases the taste. So it's better to do so. Let's see how to pour a dosa, neer dosa, onto the pan. Just drop it like as if you are splashing water, and then you can have this swirl. Grease the pan every time you are about to pour the dosa batter. This is how I have placed it on the mesh. So this is how it looks. You should be able to hear the sizzling sound as soon as you are about to pour the batter. As soon as the batter touches the pan, you should be able to hear the sizzling sound. That's when it is rightly hot. When do you know that the dosa is done? Is when you don't see any raw batter in the pan. So it takes about 1 to 2, just 1 or 2 minutes or 1.5 minutes. After you pour the batter, just open the lid and see. This is how I'm going to serve the neer dosa with the chutney, coriander chutney. This is a nice combination. You can use any kind of curries that you like, non-veg or a veg curry. Please do try this neer dosa recipe. Like, comment and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.